Welcome back. In this MOOC, we already showed you the trolley problem. We will now look at the engineer's perspective. What you will not find in the vast trolley literature is the following. Engineers and designers of technical artifacts and systems often reply to the trolley cases by saying that it is a stupid piece of railway infrastructure and a very bad design. Especially engineers immediately start to think about better system designs and innovations to prevent this tragic choice situation from arising in the first place. The infrastructure should have included, as they would suggest, early warning systems, automated braking systems, kill switches to prevent such a tragic choice for the operator near the switch. Again, this is not a legitimate move in a philosophy seminar, but it is a most interesting move in another context, namely the one that pertains to preventing deaths in rail transport and safety of rail infrastructure. What this response clearly brings to the fore is that in trolley cases, the situation is given, as you would expect in a thought experiment. Engineers, however, with their preoccupation to improve the world by engineering design and their characteristic unwillingness to take the status quo for granted, have difficulty in accepting the stipulations in the thought experiment. Their focus is on changing the world for the better by design. Their conception of responsibility, therefore, extends to the design histories which lead up to tragic choices. This dominant mode of moral thinking about trolleys, where conditions are given and immutable, draws attention away from the fact that problematic situations in reality typically do not come about as a result of the hard work of imaginative philosophers preparing for an academic paper, but as are the result of numerous prior decisions by many others, and not necessarily the final agent who faces that choice. Moral dilemmas in daily and professional life, and certainly ones that involve technology, are almost always the result of hundreds, if not thousands, of decisions and choices by design agents. Design histories thus matter in the real world, and it is as important to learn to think about the ways to prevent dilemmatic and tragic choice situations from coming into existence as it is to learn how to think about them once they have come into existence. When we are thinking about designing and developing new intelligent or autonomous cars, new high-tech systems, new infrastructures, new materials, designer foods, drugs, energy options, we are thereby shaping the choice situations or choice architectures of future users. Engineers know that the best way in real life to deal with moral problems for these situations often is by anticipation and not by waiting for dilemmas to occur and then dealing with them in a more or less acceptable way by limiting the damage. Does it mean that the study of trolley cases is useless? Not at all. The types of moral considerations, concerns, lines of reasoning, moral categories that are invoked in thinking about them can be fruitfully used in the design of high-tech innovation systems, infrastructures, and contexts where humans are near the switch or at the table. Responsible innovation is about anticipating moral choice and taking responsibility for the responsibility of others, be they fellow citizens or our grandchildren. It concerns designing and shaping technology in the understanding that future users, consumers, patients, citizens, and future generations will be stuck with what engineers and applied scientists have come up with today and have thought about or forgot to think about long before. Their ability to take responsibility will be a function of a long and detailed design history, and this applies equally to energy options, internet protocols, smart cities, and new materials. Thank you for your attention.